It's an exciting day today because I'm expecting a delivery. It's the new GivEnergy All In One battery and gateway. It's going to get delivered into the garage, so hopefully in a bit I'll go in there and do a bit of an unboxing and we can take a look at what you get included. And here it is in my nice and not quite organized garage. I think we'll start by having a look at the gateway, which is this little box on top. The all-in-one itself has come in this enormous wooden box, almost like something from Indiana Jones. It's like it's on a pallet and it's got metal reinforcements all around it. I have no idea quite how I'm going to open this yet, but I think we just have to prise these metal bits off the side. But let's start with the gateway on top first. So I will grab my Stanley knife, wherever I put that. Oh, here it is. I think I'll need to move the camera to give you a better view of this. So in the box, you've got a couple of little bags of bits. There looks to be an RJ45 coupler and an aerial, and then there's some wall plugs and bolts and a key for inside. Oh no, not for inside, to get into the cabinet, I guess. Let's take the polystyrene off very carefully. Wow, here we go. Just to show you on the bottom, there are a lot of ports for wires. You've got a connection for the all-in-one itself, connection for your solar inverter. This one, I guess, is for future use, as you can plug an extra all-in-one in. This is the load, so that'll go to your home. This is the grid input. You've got some sort of data port for communication. Again, another data port here that includes the LAN. You've got your Wi-Fi or 4G, I guess that's where the aerial will go, and a port for your EV charger. On the front of the gateway, you've got the now traditional GivEnergy, I guess, arrow diagram that lights up to tell you which direction all of the energy is flowing, similar to how you get on the front of the EV charger and all of the inverters for everything else. So let's open it up and have a look inside. Okay, well, what we have in here looks like a normal consumer unit with knobs on. So we've got, what are these? RCBOs, I think. I'm not an electrician, so I don't know for certain, but I think there are RCBOs. And you've got one for the all-in-one, you've got one for the PV inverter. There's a blanking space here for the EV charger. It says EV charger and a meter. Breaker for the load, a bypass, which I think you flip that switch to bypass the gateway totally, and then your grid here. Up here we've got a couple of what look like EM115, so like energy monitors. And let's have a look inside. I think these come off. Yep, these panels come off. Ooh, I don't think you can see on that camera, so I'll have to get a different camera out to show you. Inside here we've got, right down there, that is a LAN port, which is going to be quite useful for me. So that's where I'll plug a network connection in for monitoring. You've got, so these must be EM115 type of things, because just down here, that is a CT clamp. And that is a CT clamp over the load. Let me just check what, yes, because that's grid. that's bypass and that is load. So this CT clamp must be monitoring the house load. There must be a second CT clamp. Oh yeah, there is, just down at the bottom here, there is a black one, and that is monitoring the grid. Yeah, so black one is monitoring the grid, blue one is monitoring the house load.
Yeah, so to open it up, I've got to prise open all of these metal clips on the side of it with a screwdriver, I hope, and maybe a hammer. So I will record this, but I don't think it's going to make very interesting viewing. But let's see if we can get this lid off. Right then, let's have a look inside. Well, that was a bit of an anticlimax. It's just this and a lot of polystyrene. Well, better have a look underneath that. Okay, so clearly this thing weighs an absolute ton, so there's no way I'm going to be able to get it out of the crate on my own to show you what it looks like. But I am going to try and get the plastic covering off and open it up so we can at least have a bit of a look at it and see if we can look inside. Do you know what? I would have done that, but I have to take the sides off first. So now you've got to wait for me to take the sides off this crate. Only one injury so far, not bad. There are a couple of screws at the top of the unit here that need to be undone first. And there we go, the lid is off. Just to give you a rough idea of size comparison between the other GivEnergy products, on the left is an 8.2 kilowatt hour battery, and on the right is that cover for the new all-in-one. So here it is with the cover off. You can see there's clearly two distinct sections. I'm assuming that that section at the top is the inverter and this section down at the bottom are the batteries. I'm going to attempt to pop that bottom cover off and we can have a look at the batteries themselves. So there's the cover that I've just removed, and underneath that cover are these four battery packs. Each battery pack's got a handle on it so as you can take it out. So the idea here is it's supposed to be a modular system for installation purposes. I don't know whether it's modular for using it. I assume you need all four batteries in for it to work properly. But each battery is secured, I think, by a screw on each side, and it's the same across all of them. And I'd need to remove those screws to be able to actually remove these batteries. I don't think there's any point me bothering to try, even for the video, because they're very heavy and I don't know what I'm going to do with them. I just have to put them straight back in anyway. So I think I'm going to have to tidy up now, because I've left quite a mess in my garage. I was also hoping to show you inside this inverter cover here, but they use some sort of security screw. I don't know if I can focus on it there, but you can see it's got like a star shape with a little notch in the middle. Now I've got some screwdriver bits like that, but not quite the right size. So unfortunately, at the moment, I can't remove this cover. Maybe I'll do that in a few days and show you in another video or something. So that's about it for this video. Hopefully the next video you see with the all-in-one in is going to be it being installed instead of the AC3 unit I've got over there. I haven't got a date for installation yet, but hopefully it's very, very soon. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please give it a like, share it around, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel to see more videos like this. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.